Pound of the iron, may you cash that. Is Ishan gave Anam.
Well, being a native much speaker, I was spoken to in Gaelic alone from a very young age. So, bilingual family, my dad's not a Gaelic speaker, my mum is, so kind of brought up both languages, Gaelic and English. I suppose while I was growing up, it made me aware of being, I suppose, different, because most Scottish people can't speak Gaelic, so there was always that novelty, say something in Gaelic. People would ask me to do that in school, and maybe, I suppose, a bit proud of having a secret code language, if you like, and something that's very important to the history of Scotland as well. I went to university and did a computer studies degree, so initially I didn't think it would help me into the working world, but it did, long term, it did help me do that. Well, obviously it's impacted my recent working life, because I work developing the language now, I work for Community Gaelic. I realise there's a lot of job work related opportunities, media, teaching, Gaelic development, interpretation, there's all kinds of Gaelic related work out there. They were pressing for a Gaelic school to be opened up, because the current unit in Toe Cross Primary is bursting at the seams. There's too many pupils in there, and they're pretty much needing up open classes and corridors. It's really, really bad. There's still probably not enough children going through Gaelic medium education yet to arrest the decline in terms of the number of Gaelic speakers, native speakers that are dying every year. So we are making progress, but work still has to be done. Because this is just an event that happens to be in Gaelic. It's not an event about Gaelic. We're doing a quiz, it's not a quiz about Gaelic. So it's just a sort of, a normal event that happens to be in Gaelic, because there's this sort of notion that Gaelic can only be a school thing or a church thing or a home thing, which isn't the case. Gaelic's a language that can be used for anything.
Gentlemen, Fesker Ma, Camera Hashim and Ocht. Skunyo. Falshika Paslik, Hami a Paslik, Ach Hami a Furuch, on the Balguian and Drasa.
Well, it's always something I've wanted to learn. I used to present for the BBC before I started at STV, and travelled all over the country presenting for the BBC, and I presented in Wales for quite a while. And in Wales, even though you're in Cardiff, they're using Welsh. And I used to think it's strange, the Welsh are so passionate about their language, and there's still a huge percentage of people in Wales that still speak Welsh. So I think it's something in Scotland that we should be more passionate about. I mean, it dropped down to just about 1% of people in Scotland that were actually able to speak in Gaelic. But hopefully, the Scottish Government are working quite hard to try and reverse that. And that's it. I've just had a passion to always learn it. When I went to present in Wales, it made me even more passionate. So hence why I'm learning it now. And the mod coming to Paisley, that's a great opportunity to do that. Well, I started learning properly about 2 years ago, doing night classes in Paisley and now in Johnston. But I'll probably have private tuition in the last year as the mod gets a bit closer. I started maybe about 5 or 6 years ago. I did my first course with Saul Morostig on Sky. I started learning, but it was a remote learning course, so it was quite difficult to kind of keep up, and I ended up stopping that course. But now I'm absolutely determined. And I think the more people use the language, I mean, the thing in Wales is it was trendy for young people to use the language, all thanks to Big Brother, because there were two Welsh speakers in Big Brother at the time. And I think what we've got to try and do here is try and make it trendy again, get young people talking Gaelic, and hopefully its popularity will grow and grow. But I think it is a big social thing, and it'll be very, very interesting. I mean, obviously the mod went to Falkirk a few years ago, but when the mod comes to Paisley, I'm hoping that the Gaelic will become a much bigger thing, and it'll become very popular in Central Scotland, and hopefully West Central Scotland too.
Well, when Paisley Registrar was bidding for the mod, we started off with this Gaelic choirs competition. I've been to absolutely everyone there's been. I think it's absolutely fabulous for Paisley. It's going to do a lot for tourism, and it's going to show Paisley and his best Bibb and Tucker when they come along. Gaelic's always had a long tradition of people coming down to work in Glasgow and the surrounding areas, and they've always had a very good, strong social and cultural life. So it's nice to see that it's still working, and and the young people get involved in it. Good for the language staying alive. and it's good to see people like Sean that are taking it up, and I'm sure it's going to survive. Well, you've got the Gaelic School in Glasgow, which children like my granddaughter will go to. They go to kindergarten and then they go into school, and they learn to read Gaelic at a young age and listen to the stories. So yes, I think it's a very good thing.